Hey everyone, it's Lena here, and in this short video, I'm excited to show you how to make music with Logic and MiniLab 3. Let's dive in. Logic is naturally one of the most used DAWs, being a go-to program for many Mac users. Therefore, we made sure that it works perfectly with MiniLab 3, letting you make music with minimal mouse and keyboard action needed. Logic comes with a dedicated MiniLab 3 MIDI script, which allows MiniLab 3 to be recognized instantly after launching it alongside your DAW. To access the script, go to the MiniLab 3 website and open the resources section. There, download the script, add the folder, and install the file. First off, let's explain what we can control inside of Logic with MiniLab 3. The list includes browsing through tracks and navigating through instruments parameters, finger drumming, changing instrument presets, and sound settings with knobs and faders. And of course, controlling the timeline section with MiniLab 3's pads. To start with, we have our Logic session running with 4 tracks and instruments visible. We can browse through them with MiniLab 3's encoder. Every time we stop on one, it's highlighted and on MiniLab 3's display. To view an instrument that's on a track, simply press the main encoder once. Now, this is a bass track, and it sounds like this. Let's record it as our first musical idea. To do so, I simply press Shift plus record and start playing after the count-in. After the 4 bars, the recorded clip started to loop, as we previously set the transport section to do so. Now, let's focus on adding drums. With the main encoder, I can easily navigate to a second track, which consists of this particular drum set that I can unfold to its full view by pressing the encoder. Now, let's record this on top of the bass line, again by pressing Shift plus play on the MiniLab 3 pad. That's sweet. Another cool feature of this integration is the transport section navigation. Let's say I made a mistake in the second part of the 4-bar pattern and want to quickly re-record that part. For that, I can just press and hold Shift, plus turn the main encoder to fast forward or rewind. Now let's go to another track with a default Logic instrument on it to add keys melody. We can again open the view and preview our sound and also see the list of parameters that are used on it. We can now record, and while doing so, we can move MiniLab 3 knobs that control some of the instrument's parameters to produce movement within the sound as it is recorded. Let's enable recording and start. This one works well. Let's try to add one more sound, this time by exploring Analog Lab's library, which you can fully control from MiniLab 3. To do this, after navigating to the track, simply press Shift plus Program to activate Arturia mode. This allows you to browse through Analog Lab presets and categories, and also tweak its macro controls to explore the tone and color of the sound. Now let's find some pads that work well with our remaining sounds. This one seems just right. So now that we have our sound ready, we can prepare a recording. We will also automate Analog Lab V parameters in real time to add a bit of movement. Let's record. Thank you. Okay, and that's really it. Hopefully this video demonstrates how quick, easy, and fun it is to use MiniLab 3 with Logic. For more detailed information on MiniLab 3 and how to use it, make sure to watch the rest of our how-to videos on our channel. Thanks for watching, and see you soon.